Today on BRStv, we have our 8th episode of the Neptune Apex series. Today we're going to show you how to properly calibrate your pH probe. Hi, I'm Ryan, host of BRStv, where each week we cover a new topic related to reefing. This week we're going to do a quick episode on calibrating your pH probe. First step is to remove the plastic tip on the probe. It's perfectly normal for there to be some white crust around the tip. Basically, this is just salt creep from the storage solution. The tip should have some solution in it to keep the probe hydrated. Note that it doesn't have to be submerged or completely full. The goal is only to keep it moist. If for some reason you had a dry probe, the best bet is to soak it in a pouch of pH 4 solution for a day or so. The Apex uses a 2-point calibration. The most common pH calibrations are 4, 7, and 10. We're going to use 7 and 10 because most tanks' natural pH is between 7.8 and 8.3, which is right between 7 and 10. If you were calibrating a probe to be using a calcium reactor, which runs at a lower pH than the tank, 4 and 7 would be a better option. In most cases, it's easiest to calibrate using the Apex display. Just hit the center button to open up the main menu, scroll down to setup, then scroll down to pH. Make sure to just tap the buttons and not mash them, or you'll completely pass the options up and mess up your calibration. It'll ask what your low solution is. You can change it, but in this case we're using 7, so select that and hit enter. At this point, tear off the top of your calibration solution packet. I like to just clip off a corner so I can put the probe in at an angle and make sure it's completely submerged. The display should say settling with a number that begins to change. If it doesn't, it's probably because you forgot to screw in the BNC connector on the Apex. The number will often move rapidly at the beginning and then slow down. Don't be concerned with what the number says. We're only waiting for it to stop moving. Once it doesn't move for 10 to 20 seconds, go ahead and push OK. Then select 10 for your high solution and shake the probe off. In fact, I like to wipe it off to get the 7 solution on the outside of the probe off so it doesn't mess up the second calibration. Insert the probe into your next packet, which is 10, and repeat the same steps as you did with 7. Once it stops moving, hit OK and you're done. If you leave the probe in the solution, you can go to the home screen and it should say 10. You can also try putting it into 7 to make sure it's calibrated at both points. Keep in mind it might not be exactly 7 because you might have got a bit of 10 solution into the 7. If you have any questions or calibrating tips for your fellow reefers, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, hit that subscribe button because we do this every week. See you next week with another episode of BRStv.